We're asked to categorize the value of each exponential expression. And we categorize each expression into either the bucket less than negative 1, between negative 1 and 0, and between 0 and 1. And I encourage you to pause this video and try this out on your own. So I assume you've given a go at it. Now let's work through it together. So I just copy and pasted the exact same exercise right over here. And let's think about each of these expressions. And actually, before doing that, I actually want to draw a number line to think about these categories. So it looks like the important things to consider. You have a 0, you have 1, and then you have negative 1. This first category right over here, less than negative 1, that's all of these values right over there. Then you have the category between negative 1 and 0. That's these values right over there. And then finally, you have the category between 0 and 1. That's this category right over here. So they didn't give us a bucket for greater than 1, so I guess it's safe to assume that none of these are going to be greater than 1. But let's go each expression by each expression. So this first expression, 7 to the negative 4th power. 7 to the negative 4th power. We've already talked about several times that when you raise something to a negative exponent, this isn't somehow negative 7 to the 4th power or anything like that. This is this when you see an exponent, when you see a negative number in exponent, you should immediately think reciprocal. So this is going to be equal to 1 over 7 to the positive 4th power. And you don't even have to know what 7 to the 4th actually is. It's 2,401 if you're interested. But you don't even have to know that. You just know that this right over here is going to be a large positive number. So 1 over that is going to be a very small positive number. It's going to be between 0 and 1. This is actually 1,401th. But you don't even have to know that. This is a large number. And so you say, well, this is going to get pretty close. It's positive, so it's going to be above 0. But it's not going to be too much above 0. It's going to sit on the number line. Actually, I'm not even doing justice right over there. The way I've drew it at scale, it's not even a pixel to the right of 0 right over there. So this is going to be between 0 and 1. Now, and actually, I'll draw lines like this to show where roughly on our number line where it would sit. Now let's think about negative 7 to the 3rd power. So negative 7 to the 3rd power. Well, this is the same thing as negative 7 times negative 7 times negative 7. And you could also think about this as negative 1 times 7 times negative 1 times 7 times negative 1 times 7, which is the same thing as you have 3 negative 1s being multiplied together. So negative 1 to the 3rd power times 7 to the 3rd power. Well, what's negative 1 to the 3rd power? Well, it's negative 1 times negative 1, which would be positive 1, but then times another negative 1. So this is negative 1 right over here. So this is going to be equal to negative, and let me write it this way. You could write it either as negative, I could write it like this, negative 7 to the 3rd power. So 7 to the 3rd, once again, we don't even have to know what it is. This is going to be a large positive value, but then we're negating it. If we had 7 to the 3rd, it would be greater than 1, but negative 7 to the 3rd is definitely less than negative 1. So this fits into that bucket right over there. Now we have negative 7 to the negative 4th. Negative 7 to the negative 4th. So let me write it over here. So negative 7 to the negative 4th. And this could be a little daunting because you have a negative base raised to a negative exponent. But whenever I see a negative exponent, the first thing I worry about, or the first thing my brain wants to do, is take a reciprocal. So this is going to be 1 over negative 7, 1 over negative 7 to the 4th power. And once again, the same idea as we just saw over here, we could view this as 1 over negative 1 to the 4th power times 7 to the 4th power, which is going to be equal to negative 1 to the 4th power. This is just going to be equal to 1. So this is going to be equal to 1 over 7 to the 4th power. Well, we've already thought about what 1 over 7 to the 4th power is. It is between 0 and 1. So this right over here is between 0 and 1. Another way you could think about it, this is going to be 1 over negative 7 times negative 7 times negative 7 times negative 7. You have a negative times a negative times a negative times a negative. Well, that's going to be a positive. So it's positive 7 to the 4th power. Now let's think about this one right over here. Negative 7 to the negative 5th power. So let me write this out. Negative 7 to the negative 5th power. Well, once again, as soon as you see that negative exponent, I want to just take the reciprocal so I don't have a negative exponent anymore. So it's 1 over negative 7 to the 5th power. And we could rewrite this as 1 over negative 1 to the 5th times negative 7, or sorry, times 7 to the 5th, times 7 to the 5th, which is equal to, well, what's a negative 1 to the 5th power? Well, a negative 1 raised to an odd power is going to be a negative 1. So this is going to be negative 1 over 7 to the 5th power. So where is 1 over 7 to the 5th power? Well, that would be really close to 0. This would be 1 over 7 to the 5th would be a very small positive number. But now we're taking the negative of that. So we're going to jump onto the other side of 0. So this is going to be between negative 1 and 0. Between negative 1 and 0. And then finally, negative 7 to the 5th power. Well, that's just going to be this. Once again, you could view that as negative 1 times 7 to the 5th power, which is the same thing as negative 1 to the 5th times 7 to the 5th, which is the same thing as negative 7 to the 5th. 7 to the 5th is a very large number, larger than 1. So the negative of that is going to be a very negative number. It's going to be less than negative 1. So this is going to be less than negative 1 right over here. So now let's take our results. And since I have a bad memory, I'm essentially probably going to have to think through it again. And let's actually put them in the buckets. 7 to the negative 4th power. This is not going to be a negative value. This is 1 over 7 to the 4th. This is going to be between 0 and 1. Negative 7 to the 3rd power. That's essentially, if you take 7 to the 3rd power, you get a very large positive number. But then, that's going to be times negative 1 to the 3rd power. It's going to be the negative version of that. So that's going to be less than negative 1. Negative 7 to the negative 4th. Well, we already determined, especially because this ends up being 1 over negative 7 to the 4th power, and that's an even exponent. It ends up being the same as 7 to the negative 4th. And then you had negative 7 to the negative 5th power. So once again, that was going to be 1 over negative 7 to the 5th power, and so we found that to be between negative 1 and 0. And then finally, this right over here is going to be, it's going to be negative, and it's going to be a very negative number. It's less than negative 1. And so those are our choices, and we can check our answer, and we got it right.